The ET7 has the original springs that came on the governor. I put some black electrical tape around this flywheel, and I have two reflective strips approximately 180 degrees apart. Showing 3200 RPM, we divide that by 2, so this is running about 1600 RPM. With the original springs, that's about how much those weights are expanding. I'm going to remove these and replace them with weaker springs. This is the original spring from the ET7. And this is a spring that I purchased on eBay. I'll put a link to those in the description for this video. I don't know how much longer those will be available. So I'm going to take this spring, and I'm going to stretch it. And I'm going to stretch it a little more until I deform it, so that the coils end up being about the same length as this one. And that will weaken that spring a little bit. You have to be careful when you do this, because you don't want to stretch it too far, because you won't be able to put it back. You stretch it out, and you stretch it a little bit further until when it relaxes, it's about that long. We can look at the springs now, and we can see that the coils are noticeably further apart. I think you can see the weights are going out further, and they're staying out longer than they were before. You can hear that the engine's running slower. We're below 1200 RPM. So that's slowed this down quite a bit. And it sounds a lot more like a hit-and-miss engine. And I would assume if I stretch those springs a little more, I could get down to about 1,000 RPM. I've stretched those springs a little more. Now it sounds like a hit-and-miss. Under 1,000 RPM. Remember, we've got two reflective tapes. We have to divide this reading by 2. To 1,000 RPM. About the same. Now you can see those weights come out here to a larger diameter, and they stay out there for quite a while. This sounds good. Just over 900 RPM.